Occasionally, you may get a request from a customer to create an order for them. You can achieve this by creating a draft order. Draft orders allow you to manually create an order for your customer and send them an invoice directly from your admin. Hey there, Lucy here from Shopify. Today, we're going to talk about what a draft order is and how to create one from your admin. Draft orders are like saved carts for your customers, and they are converted to an order once the customer has paid. With draft orders, you can manually add products, choose shipping, apply taxes, and even pick payment terms. You can create a draft order either by duplicating an existing order or creating a new draft order. When you duplicate an order, the draft order contains the same product and customer information as the original order. However, discounts and shipping rates are not duplicated. To duplicate an order, start in your Shopify admin and click Orders. Click on the order that you wish to duplicate. Click the More Actions menu in the top right corner, then click Duplicate. If you're duplicating an existing draft order, then click on Drafts under Orders and follow the same steps. Once you've duplicated the order, a copy of the draft order will open. Remember, the draft will contain the same product information and customer information as the original order. You'll need to apply any shipping fees and discounts that are needed. To create a new draft order, start in your Shopify admin and click Orders. In the top right corner, click Create Order. A new draft order will open. Start by adding products to your draft order. For existing products, you can use the search bar or use the browse button to find your products. Be sure to check the inventory levels of any products that you're adding to the order. If the product has an inventory of 0, then the draft order will create a negative inventory. After you've made your selection, click Add. You can also add custom items to draft orders by clicking Add Custom Item. From here, we'll add the custom item's name, price, and quantity. You can also select if the custom item is taxable and if it requires shipping. If the item requires shipping, make sure to enter the weight of the product to ensure that accurate shipping rates are calculated. When you're ready, click Done to add the custom item to your draft order. On the draft order page, you can easily adjust the quantity of any of the products or remove them. Once you've added your items, you can also reserve them by clicking Reserve Items. This temporarily places a hold on the items but doesn't adjust their actual inventory levels in your Shopify admin. If you want to use location-based shipping rates for the order, then you'll need to add an existing customer or create a new one. You can look up or create new customers using the search bar. If you accidentally add the wrong customer, you can easily remove them and try again. You can organize your orders by adding tags to them. To learn more about tags, click on the link in the description below. You can either select from previously created tags by clicking in the text box, or you can create a new one by typing the name of the tag in the text box and then selecting them. Next, you can apply discounts to your draft orders. You can apply discounts to individual products or the whole order. First, we'll show you how to add discounts to an individual product. To add discounts to individual items, click the product's price beneath its title. You can apply a discount as an amount of the selling price or a percentage off of the selling price. You can include a reason for the discount if you choose. When you're finished, click Apply. You'll now see the discounted price in blue beside the original price, which is crossed out. To add a discount to the entire order, click Add Discount under the Payment section. This discount is applied in addition to any item-specific discounts that have already been added to the order. If the order requires shipping, click Add Shipping. Here, you'll see the options to choose from any location-based shipping your store offers, free shipping, or an option to create a custom shipping rate for the order. Once you've made your selection, click Apply. Finally, draft orders include taxes based on your store's tax settings and the customer's shipping address. If you don't have a shipping address on file, then taxes are based on the customer's billing address. If you don't want to charge taxes on the order, click Tax and uncheck the option. If you need more time to prepare your draft order, then you can save it for later by clicking Save. When you're ready, you can send the draft order to a customer via email or manually collect payment. Now you know how to create a draft order. Thank you for watching.